See, you needed me, so it ain't gonna be between me and you. But see, it's some other people that we got to worry about. So that there'll be no contention between me and you. I tell you what we gonna do, we gonna separate this thing. But see, this was a Lot idea. This was Abraham idea. So he said, we'll separate them. We'll put some of them over here, some of them over there. And then the ones in the middle, they crazy, they all right. They all right, they the all right crew. Hallelujah. But listen at this, listen. He say, it's not the whole land before thee, separate thyself, I pray thee for me. If you take the left hand, I go to the right hand. Mm-hmm. Or if you take the right, I go to the left. Uh-huh. So now you've been given an option.
That's right.
You've been given a choice to the whole matter. And see, that's where wisdom should step in.
Come on, preacher.
See, you gotta have wisdom when it comes to making choices in your life.
Go ahead.
And instead of not going to Uncle Abraham and saying, you know what, Uncle Abraham? We're going to get these folks together. Mm-hmm. We're going to find out what the problem is.
Yeah.
Come on. That's what we're going to do. And we're going to try to straighten this thing out.
Yes.
Because see, I'm using wisdom because I know as long as God bless you,
that's right.
He's going to bless me.
Come on now.
Stand. I ain't finna walk away from my blessing. I don't know about nobody else.
My God.
I don't care how it look.
Yes.
I don't care how it sound.
Yes.
I know blessings when I see blessings. I ain't walking away.
Go ahead.
Hallelujah. And look at this. It say, and Lot lifted up his eyes. See, you got to watch what you be looking at. Lot lifted up his eyes and he saw. See, that's why you got to close your eye gate.
Yeah.
You got to close your eye. Stop looking at stuff in the natural and try to look at it spiritually.
Yeah,
so. See, we so anointed and appointed.
Uh-huh.
We look at everything in the natural realm.
Jesus.
That's why we get off. That's why we miss the shift.
Yeah.
Hey. We look at it in the natural. We don't use our spiritual eyes. Mm-hmm. We're anointed people. We've been called by God.
Come on.
Been called by God. We are the chosen ones. We are the high priestess of God. We are chosen generation.
Yes.
Yes. We look at things in the natural.
Yes.
And then we miss the shelf.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It said Lot lifted up his eyes and beheld all the plains of Jordan, that it was well watered everywhere before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah.
Yes.
Even as the Garden of Eden, it was like the Garden of Eden. It was beautiful.
Oh my God.
Brother Lot looked out there and saw that. His mind just got carried away with him.
My God.
So I said, oh my God, all that? Who was on all that?
That's right.
Jesus.
Not once did he repent for what his men did.
My God, come on now.
In the book of Job say he knew what his sons and daughters was doing.
Right.
He knew it. He went before God and gave a sacrifice to them for their wicked ways.
That's right.
God don't kill them.
Yes.
I know they hurt mama. They probably sleeping with each other, but they're my children. Don't kill them. Maybe I get them straight now.
Right.
Give them another chance, God.
My God.
Give them another chance. I know what they did last night.
Uh-huh.
My God.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Hallelujah. One more chance. But God said, how many more chances you need before you get it right? How many? Because we be running out of chances. Hallelujah. Some of us are on borrowed time. On borrowed time. Time is running out. We are borrowed time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Then it said, Lot chose him all the plans of Jordan. See, Lot made the wrong choice.
Yes,
because of the choices that we make in life.
My
that determines our destiny. It determines our future. Some of the choices that we make, it determines our future, where we're going to end up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, you're a free will agent. Yeah, you got choices.
Yes.
You got choices, but the choices that you make in your lifetime. There's 7 weeks left in this year. And several people in here that have choices that they got to make.
Jesus.
It's gonna dictate to how their future ends up. Seven weeks left. And there's some people that have got some choices that they got to make. And some of them are life and death situations. Some of the choices that we make are going to take some people out of here. Because of the choices that we make. Gotta have a relationship with God. Gotta talk to God before you make any kind of decision. God, is this where you want me to be? Am I making the right decision? God, if it's not right, get me. Tell me, God, tell me. He'll tell you. Show me a sign. He'll give you a sign. God, if he the one sent him away, God will send him away. God, if he the one bring him back, the devil bring him back. God, you sure he the one? This stuff don't go right. God, I know he the one sent him away. God will send him away. But God, you know I love him. Do you think he the one? The devil sent him back. And then you end up with it. And then your life go to hell. But that's the choice that you made. Because when you ask God, well, he's the one, he took him away from you. And then you say, well, send him back. And the devil heard you. And he sent him back to you.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Warning comes before destruction. Just because it look good don't make it good. Everything that look good ain't good, baby. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You better get the spirit of discernment. Not discern the person, but discern that spirit that operates on the inside of us. See, that's what you're missing it. We want to discern the person and not the spirit. Better discern that spirit. Know what spirit they operate in. Hallelujah. 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 And it says, Lot chose him all the plans to join the Lot journey east. Abraham dwelled in the land. But down in verse 13, where Lot went at, it said the men were wicked there. Hallelujah. Not only were they wicked there, because see, Lot and Abraham already knew what the deal was down in Sodom. They knew who was down there in Sodom. They knew because they was right there. They could see it every day. So how are you going to see a situation every day and not know what the encounter of it is? How you going to walk into sin with your eyes open? Your eyes, they closed, your eyes open. You see it before you even get there. And yet it's still, you're going to walk right on into it like a real fool. And then when you get up in there, you want to go to crying out to God. God, save me. God, deliver me. But you walked into it. You did that yourself. You knew what it was. You knew what it looked like. You know what time it was when you went in there. It wasn't no secret. God opened it up for you. You had an open vision of the whole situation. And you walked right on into it. Because of what you saw with your natural eyes. Instead of you using your spiritual eyes, you're looking at it natural and so. And then lust going to sit in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It wasn't no secret. It was not no secret. It was, ain't nothing gonna be hid that ain't gonna be uncovered. Especially when it comes to God, people. God is uncovering stuff for us. He said he gonna let us walk into the enemy camp.